And then, and it's a penalty for pinching the ball, and Collier rubs his nose, and he's not wishing anything. Well, it may be. Well, that was a chance, but it's also a chance for 2 points by Neil Fox. But on this Wembley day of peculiar goal kicking, I won't forecast what's going to happen. Let you watch it. 10 points to five for Wakefield. And Fox chance for 2 points. It's a goal. Wakefield at Trinity 12, Wigan 5. And left to play, 18 minutes. So this cracking, hard, rugged cup final, Eric Ashton's going to put a long one and he's mucked it. Oh dear, and he's knocked it. It's a knock on and it's on the 10-yard mark. All the scrums from the ball goes out of play must be on the 10-yard mark. That's the idea. Can't measure 10 yards, no. It's a league actually. Holiday. And that's a good rear guard position as Steve Marshall Montgomery has been talking about. By the way, it's a penalty to Wigan. And Eric Ashton will surely take this. Got to go because these 2 points are very important in as much that the other team's got to score twice to get past it. So if he kicks this, it's back to one try, one goal, different. Well, 5 to 12. Ashton a little hurriedly, realizing time nothing highly on his side. Good one, it's a good one, he's trying to carry to go. Points to Wakefield, 7 points to Wigan, and this vast Wembley crowd still wonder where this cup is going to, and so do I. I don't know what's going to be the last quarter. It's going to be another long one by Neil Fox. Four or three Wigan players are right over the line. They don't want it to go dead. If you can have it, and there is David Bolton, who was off injured. Looking for Ashton. Jack and I Sampson. In a little bit of the referee with the penalty. Now going to carry. Taken by Yupa Puta. Collier, the man who usually sticks it up his jumper. Down a great big Methodist dummy in. Poynton. Hillgard. Harold Poynton and Brian McKean, number 10. He's all right, he can do that. I said he can do that, I mean, oh, he's lost the ball again. Wakefield ball. Neil Fox, no, Koecher, long one. Koecher's got Billy Boston to beat, and he doesn't. Although he's done very well against the mighty Boston. We still got to see one of the famous Boston runs. Holiday. Wakefield to Wigan. And again, Wakefield out of position to play the ball. Wilkie save, Jack Wilkinson, commonly and kindly known as Wilkie. Yeah, lines up. Samson. 15 yards out, 15 yards from the Wigan line, and I'm looking for Fox to see if he's going to get in position to have a drop. Gary Round up from the full-back position. Ashton, number three, Boulder coming in to help. 12 points to 7, one try, one goal in it. And 13 minutes left for play. Scissors dummy, 25 line, and it's Wigan's 25 line. Vasanovic dummy into Greenwood. Something's got to break here. I don't know if something's got to break. No. Something's got to break soon, one way or another. This attack can't go out on without something happens. Either Wakefield's going through or Wigan's going to get the breakaway. Poynton. Poynton is a much better defender than he is an attacker. And it's something broken. It's a knock on. Wakefield's lost the ball. A number of times Wakefield must have dropped the ball in possession. Both down. An interception! What a sensational try! There he is. Well, I did not think it was going to break. What a Harold Poynton. One of the greatest defenders in the game. Saw that he couldn't get across to the tackle, went in for the inside pass, and very kindly, with the help of a Wigan player, took the ball and scored what probably is one of the most sensational tries that's ever been seen at Wembley, if not the best, a remarkable one. That makes Wakefield 15, Wigan 7, with Fox chance to add 2 points. Wakefield, who very, very few people ever gave them to have a chance in this. All the critics, all the scribes, all the pundits, or most of them, said it was Wigan's cup. But at this moment, Wakefield have got a 10-point lead. But the cup's never won till that final whistle goes. Not in this game. And not with Wigan. Wakefield are a very happy, confident lot at this moment. Understandably so too. Knock off. Good times. I mean, I've only told you that, haven't I? I'm going to get me down. Who's down? I'm going to pass my shoelace. Somebody will have to get up hurt. Done by him. I wouldn't. I mean, it's good will have come loose accidentally. There's a lot of holes to put it to. It's got to. It's a long race anyway. Takes a lot of time up, does that? Ah, it takes longer and longer when it's wrestling. I don't know, there's 2 more holes to do yet. That's all right. And, it's all right. Is it only 4 knots to do now? I don't, that's it. Good boy. Don Vine, only a Welshman could do that. Don Vine, all my friends in Wales. I won't be there. 17 points to Wakefield, 7 points to Wigan, and 8 minutes left for play. Wakefield and his penalty to Wigan, and I'm not too interested to see Eric Ashton's tactics. He's a very shrewd tactician, Ashton. Find us other shoelaces loose now. We won't bother with that one. Eric Ashton is going to kick for touch, so he's obviously going for that try and a goal, which is so vital for Wigan at this moment. And it's a good one. And according to the flag there, Wigan have got the win, but we haven't been able to really tell it by the pattern of play. Miles, Stanoff, Pitchford, there we can see. I'm just trying to look what they might be doing. They're going for the try. We're going to get the ball with Rory Davies coming in on the burst. Bolton is still a little bit dazed because he's staying at home at fullback. That's the movement. And it did go pointing again. I have a point in this remarkably good tackler. What a little power. Boxers, Lyon, Pierman, Pierman and Poynton, apart from beginning with Beach, tackle like each other, very energetic. That's the 10-yard mark, you can see, the Wakefield Trinity 10-yard mark. Jollier, and he's lost it, and he's lost it. Pitchford, Bolton's up now, extra man, Pitchford again. No, I mean, now then, are we going to see this Boston effort? And a chance for Boston. This is Boston now. He's got 15 yards to go. He's past it. It must be a try in the corner now. A brilliant tackle. Brilliant tackle. But it's Wigan right into it now. A try is so important. They've got the extra man. They must score this time. Carlton must score in the corner. It must be done. Well, Alan David there. And Frankie Carlton. I'm looking at the blackhead. We're going to come out and see Frankie Carlton, blackhead. That's right, number 5, the scorer. So, 17 points to 10. Well, this match is still anybody's game. And incidentally, Wakefield have got a man injured. We'll follow the goal kick. But Harold Poynton has been attended to by Paddy Armour. Now, this is a very, very vital kick for Eric. There you are. Very good. It's Eric Ashton. If he kicks this, then there's only one try and one goal in it. It's a hard kick, but he's been kicking confidently. 17-10, it's a port hard. Now he's missed it. He's fluffed it. We'll have a look at Poynton. Is he coming off? No, he's not coming off. So 17 points to 10. Some points in it. And 5 minutes left. There we are. Wait till 17. We get 10. 27 points. Well, you had your money's worth. I hope you've enjoyed it. It's talked about this being one of the classics. It's kind of been a hard one. A dropout only. And it's time for the long one. That's what he does. He puts the long one right down. Oh, and well followed. Seems to me as if Wakefield seems to have a bit of the wind. Although it's probably going in circles, certainly. He's getting length in the dropouts. Turner well taken. Turner, the skipper of Wakefield Trinity. Wakefield had never lost at Wembley. He won the Royal Cup final in 1960. And last year, they beat Huddersfield. this is where the strength of Turner comes into it, and Sampson. Now Wakefield will no doubt stick a little more than they have been. Wilkinson will have a go down the middle. He'll bore his head through them if need be. Pierman. Sometimes when you see a flash of a number, you think maybe 3/4, 13. Sampson, 10. Oh, Neil Fox are kicking a follow through, but the ball is bowled over the line, but it nearly bounced the wrong way. Wow. Two to three minutes left for the play. And it's now this is on the way. Fox. I was gonna look for Fox for a drop, but he's not in position. All right, then round and round and round we go. Which way you go now? It's still going. Had a very good game point then. Turner, Pierman, Poitzer in for a try. Well, this fella Poitzer, who's only recently come into regular league football, comes to Wembley after only about a dozen or so games and gets a winner's medal. They're fantastic. Effort and Koitzer opposite the redoubtable Billy Boston. No wonder the veteran Jack Wilkinson, who is a bit of a mimic off, on and off the field, is certainly quite an achievement. 20 points to 10. And Neil Fox has the chance for a 2 points bonus with 1 minute left for play. Well, that's how regularly football goes. Goals, 4 tries, 20 points. Wigan, 2 goals, 2 tries, 10 points. And it's a long one. Straight to Greenwood. Greenwood got Carlton to beat. But he decides he'll go the long way around. Up from South Africa anyway. Colin Greenwood. Vasanovic. Oh, he's getting a bit hard. It's a bit late to get hard now. But at least that hard. Whites of Wakefield against the Reds of Lancashire. And Vines of the Principality will used to all that dropping around. And his sight stepped round the photographers. Young Ian Brooks, newcomer virtually into big football, will never forget that moment. What a joyous moment. And I don't know whether his mother is here, but she's one of his greatest fans. She'll be very pleased whether she's here or not. And that's Wakefield at 23 points. Wigan 10. And it is time, according to our reckoning. Two points for 25. No, just limited over. Wait till 25. Wigan 10, as you can see. Well, this is a remarkable display by Wakefield, who were not considered the first part of the week to have a great chance. But Derek Ashton and I discussed this last week. Cup tied at 50-50. And Wakefield are always in with a chance with men like Fox around the place. 25 points to 10, and there goes the... No, he doesn't. No, it's not time. You can all sit down, you lads in the front. Everybody thought it was time. But Wilkie had run forward and he'd got to wait till the ball came to the 10-yard mark. Let it go, and this time it is still a scrum. And the referee is now looking at Mr. Battersby, who with his, he's a test judge, and with his flag straight up, his signal there is 1 minute. So he's probably taking something off for injury time. Well, he's going to have one more minute of this Rugby League Cup final if the scrummagers will get up and do their job. Make the ball now. Another scrum. And there goes the whistle. Wigan 25 points. Wigan Wakefield 25 points. Wigan. Number of times Wakefield must have dropped the ball in possession. Well done. Now this is. Oh, it's an interception! It's a sensational try by Boynton! An interception! What a sensational try! There he is. It's in and it goes. Had a very good game, Boynton. Turner. Spearman. Fights it, fights it in for a try. Roof's going to score under the post. This young lad's got a try. And he sides, steps round the photographers, and it is time according to our reckoning. That goes for his 2 points. A joyous moment for Derek Turner. Tough, solid forward. And there's his club gem on the left. Two miles from Montgomery to present the cup. And what about it, Derek? One for us, one for all those boys.
Tremendous career at Wakefield. Played there about 15, 16 seasons. So I've got a lot of feeling for the club, although later years I did go to other clubs to help out, basically. But my heart's always been at Wakefield, and the team then was a tremendous team, and that was the start of Wakefield Trinity getting on the world map because we were that successful at that particular time in the early 60s.